Hi, it's Kiffin Lobates here, and today I thought I would talk a bit about what the ERC in token standards such as ERC-20 and ERC-721 actually stands for. And the simple answer is it stands for Ethereum Request for Comment. And what the Ethereum guys did in the early days was adopt some of the methodologies and practices of the founders of the internet. Back in 1969, people in the network working group who were designing protocols for standardizing the internet came up with a method for people to propose changes to the internet and improvements and advancements to the internet. And what they did was they called these RFCs, requests for comments, because the idea was that the internet should be open and anybody who was bright enough and enthusiastic enough should be able to participate in its improvement. And so the internet has all these different RFCs. There are literally thousands of them, and every time somebody thinks that there's something that could be done better, it's proposed in the form of an RFC. And Ethereum does the same thing. The ERC indicates that someone has requested that people comment on and criticize their proposal for improving Ethereum. But it's a little bit more subtle than that, because ERCs are a specific subset of an improvement proposal, a group called EIPs, Ethereum Improvement Proposals. And EIPs cover all improvements to Ethereum, whether it be at the protocol level or whether it be about how standards in documentation should be improved, or indeed interfaces for smart contracts. And the subset that ERCs represent is proposals for standards for things at the application level, so standards for smart contracts. And that's why all the token proposals that you see are called ERCs, although actually you can look them up as EIPs as well. So if you want to see what the standard for fungible tokens ERC-20 is, you can search for ERC-20, or you can indeed search for EIP-20, and you'll find the documents are pretty much the same. In fact, hopefully they're identical. So there you have it. The reason why we have ERC-20 and ERC-721 and ERC-1155 and so on and so forth is because they are proposals for standards for things at the application level. They're proposals for standards for smart contracts. If a proposal is for something that is not a smart contract related issue, then it'll be an EIP. Anyway, I hope that little history lesson helps clear things up and explains a few things to you, and I'll see you all in the next video soon. Bye for now.